السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام الأتمان الأكملان على نبينا الأمين وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد، قال الله تبارك وتعالى في القرآن المجيد والفرقان الحميد: وأحسنوا إن الله يحب المحسنين. وقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في سنته الصحيحة الصريحة الشريفة: الإحسان أن تعبد الله كأنك تراه، فإن لم تكن تراه فإنه يراك. الحمد لله. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We glorify Him. We seek His refuge. And we ask Him for help in each and everything that we do. May the peace, blessings, and mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be upon our last and final messenger, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and upon all the previous prophets, their noble companions, their noble families, and upon all those who follow their footsteps until the last day. Alhamdulillah, it is another opportunity that Allah Jalla Jalaluhu has granted us for us to continue reminding ourselves issues regarding the most important concept in Islam, and that is the concept of At-Tawheed. Tawheed, which is the source of peace in this dunya and more so in akhirah when we meet Allah Jalla Jalaluhu wa taqaddasat asma'uhu. And as we know, we are going through a short risala by the name خُذْ عَقِيدَتَكَ مِنَ الْكِتَابِ وَالسُّنَّةِ الصَّحِيحَةِ. Take your creed from the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the sound sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the book is in the form of questions and answers. And today, insha'Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, we will be going through the fifth question, which concerns the concept of al-ihsan. As we know, ihsan is the highest level among the level of the deen. مراتب الدين أعلى مرتبة من مراتب الدين. The highest level among the levels of deen. As we know, the first level is al-Islam, the second one al-Iman, and the third one al-Ihsan. And our today's question reads: ما هو الإحسان؟ أو ما هو الإحسان في العبادة؟ What is إحسان in عبادة؟ And the Sheikh responded to the question by saying: الإحسان هو مراقبة الله تبارك وتعالى في العبادة. قال الله تبارك وتعالى: الذي يراك حين تقوم وتقلبك في الساجدين. وقال صلى الله عليه وسلم: الإحسان أن تعبد الله كأنك تراه، فإن لم تكن تراه فإنه يراك. So inshallah ta'ala, we will go through the notes which has been written by the Sheikh, and then we will briefly explain Ihsan in general, its different types, and see how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have encouraged us in many verses in his book to practice this concept of Ihsan in our day-to-day activities. Sheikh says, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, according to his explanation, is that Ihsan is to be aware of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Almighty. This is an act of ibadah. نَحْنُ فِي مَجْلِسِ الذِّكْرِ. We have gathered here في بيت من بيوت الله لله تبارك وتعالى بإذن الله. We are here for the sake of Allah This is an act of worship. This is an ibadah. الذي يراك حين تقوم. Allah knows that you are here. Allah knows that you are in His house for ibadah. And this is not in vain. It is well documented, well recorded. And some of us, perhaps this act of sitting here this morning might be a reason for us to be admitted to the highest abode in the Jannah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. بإذن الله تبارك وتعالى. So Allah يراك. Allah knows whatever you do, any time that you worship Him, at any gathering, at any moment. وَتَقَلُّبَكَ فِي السَّاجِدِينَ And your movement among those who prostrate themselves before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have just done our prostration before Allah, worshipping Allah in this important ibadah, ibadatu salah. فَاللَّهُ تَبَارَكَ وَتَعَالَى عَلَىٰ عِلْمٍ تَامٍ بِذَلِكَ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is well aware of that. So if that is the case, then it is upon the servant also to feel the same, that you are seeing Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is in front of Allah and you are worshipping Him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as if you are seeing Him. And as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, فَإِن لَمْ تَكُنْ تَرَاهُ Then if you are convinced that you can't see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in front of you, then as per the previous verse, then فَإِنَّهُ يَرَاكَ Rest assured that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sees you. So have the full concentration. Have proper khushu' in your salah. Engage Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Feel that you are speaking to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala directly. And as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam informed us, as you recite Surah Al-Fatiha, as you say Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, Allah responds. Every verse that you recite, Allah responds. And someone might ask, how come that Allah responds to millions and billions of people who pray at the same time? Similar question was asked to Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu. He was asked, كيف يحاسب الله تبارك وتعالى الخلائق يوم القيامة? That huge crowds, billions and trillions of people, how comes that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make their hisab in a very short moment? Or at the same time, Abdullah ibn Abbas said, يُحَاسِبُهُمْ مَرَّةً وَاحِدَةً كَمَا يَرْزُقُهُمْ مَرَّةً وَاحِدَةً Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will perform that particular act just as He provides for them at the same time. We are all inhaling oxygen this particular moment. Who does that? It is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Failure to which, or if you fail to get the natural oxygen, that is very, very costly. It will cost you millions of shillings. But Allah gives for free, and He gives to all the humanity, billions of people, and billions of creatures at the same time. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sees us, hears whatever we say at the same time. So it is always for the servant of Allah, for a believer, for a mu'min, to reach that level of ihsan and to always to be conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In this question, the Shaykh talks about ihsan specifically in ibadah. But as we know, ihsan encompasses almost everything. Because this is an order from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when He said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَأْمُرُ بِالْعَدْلِ وَالْإِحْسَانِ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands you, Allah enjoins justice and ihsan. And this ihsan, what is it? Scholars say ihsan is goodness or being excellent in whatever that you do. When we worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, be excellent in ibadah. In mu'amalat, in your relations and interaction with other people, other creatures, be excellent in that. So ihsan is required in ibadah. Ihsan is required in mu'amalat. Ihsan even is required to animals. Ihsan is even required to those individuals who wrong you in one way or the other. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the previous verse, He talks about ihsan in ibadah. Coming to mu'amalat, we are required to do ihsan to our parents, after our Lord, the people who deserve our obedience the most are our parents. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, ووصينا الإنسان بوالديه إحسانا. We are required to do إحسان, to do good, to be excellent toward our relations with our parents, whether they are alive or dead. When they are alive, of course, that is understood. When they are dead, then they deserve our frequent prayers, our frequent istighfar, our frequent dua. One of the salaf was asked by an individual, how will I know that I am a pious servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? كيف أعرف أنني رجل صالح? He was asked, how will I know that I'm a pious individual? I'm a righteous individual. I'm doing my best, but I will never know that. He said that look at your relationship with your parents. How frequent do you do dua to them? Because the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, إذا مات الإنسان انقطع عنه عمله إلا من ثلاث. And among the three which was mentioned, أو ولد صالح يدعو له, or a pious child who makes dua to his parents. So one of the signs to show that an individual, he has some elements of piety, is his frequent remembrance to his parents. And there are some individuals who will be admitted to the highest level in Jannah on the day of Qiyamah, and they will be surprised, and they will be assured that they did not work for that. They will say, how comes? We are at these levels. Compared to our deeds, we don't think we worked for this. And it will be said to them, لِاسْتِغْفَارِ وَلَدِكَ لَكَ. This is because of the frequent istighfar of your child for you. So al-ihsan, al-ihsan ila al-walidain, birrihima, wal-ihsan ilayhima, wal-du'a'u lahuma. Not only that, even after they have departed, one of the things that are required as ihsan to the parents, doing good to the friends of your own parents. It is said that once Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu anhu, he met a Bedouin in the streets of Makkah. He welcomed him, hugged him, and then he rided with him in his own camel. And he did a lot of ihsan to them. He did a lot of ikram to them. He welcomed him and honored him so much. And people told him, Ya Abdullah ibn Umar, this is a Bedouin. He doesn't even value all these things that you are doing to him. Just a small kindness was sufficient for him. Abdullah ibn Umar said, هذا كان رفيقا أو صديقا لعمر رضي الله عنه. This was a friend to Umar. He deserves more than this, because the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he encouraged a child to always do good to the friends of his own parents. What about the parents themselves? So الإحسان إلى الوالدين, الإحسان إلى الأقرباء, doing good to the family relatives and family members. This is something that Islam has encouraged. وإيتاء ذي القربى, إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى. Doing good to the relatives and family members. And unfortunately today, one of the problems that we have, people are not in good terms even with the closest members of their own families, their own brothers, their own sisters, because of materialistic things. Perhaps because they have quarreled because of the wealth that they inherited from their parents. Because they quarrel because of their husbands or wife. For trivial reasons, people are not in good terms. And yet, we are told, silatul rahim, joining the kinship ties, is something that Islam has encouraged. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, "Laysa al-wasilu bil mukafi." A person who joins the family ties as he has been commanded by Islam, not that particular individual who pays back, that so and so he calls me, he does good to me, we are in good terms, then I will also do to the same to him. But so and so, he doesn't care about me, he doesn't ask about me, I am not also concerned about him. That is not Islam. The Prophet says, وَلَكِنَّ الْوَاصِلَ الَّذِي يَصِلُ مَنْ قَطَعَهُ. A real follower of the teachings of Islam with regard to joining the family ties is a person who reaches out to people who are distancing from him, people who don't care about him. Perhaps when he was down, they never asked about him. Today he is better than them. He's looking for them. He's assisting. He's reaching out. That is Islam. So al-ihsanu ila al-iqriba, الإحسان إلى الجار, the neighbors. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, من كان يؤمن بالله واليوم الآخر فليحسن إلى جاره. Whomsoever believes in Allah on the last day, let him do good to his neighbors. And one of the goods that expected of us is to be patient with the difficulties and challenges and harmful things that reach us from our neighbors. To be tolerant with them, to advise them in a nice way, and so forth and so on. Among the people who deserve our ihsan is al-yatama, the orphans and the poor. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَأَحْسِنْ كَمَا أَحْسَنَ اللَّهُ إِلَيْكَ وَبَتَغِ فِي مَا آتَاكَ اللَّهُ الدَّارَ الْآخِرَةِ وَلَا تَنْسَ نَصِيبَكَ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا وَأَحْسِنْ كَمَا أَحْسَنَ اللَّهُ إِلَيْكَ. Do good just like Allah has done good to you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought from very far. Perhaps we were born in the villages. We were brought up in very poor families. Allah has blessed us, and today we have more than what satisfies us. Then reach out to masakin, reach out to the poor, reach out to the yatama. Assist, just like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did good to you. And that is one of the most important acts of worship in Islam. Assisting people, solving people's problems, fulfilling the needs of people, clearing debts for people. These are things which are loved by Allah. And on the day of Qiyamah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He will do to you just the same as you have been doing good to people in this dunya. That is the most important thing we can do. As the poet says, وَأَفْضَلُ النَّاسِ مِنْ بَيْنِ الْوَرَىٰ رَجُلٌ تُقْضَىٰ عَلَىٰ يَدَيْهِ لِلنَّاسِ حَاجَاتُ. The best of humans are those who fulfill the needs of people, who do good to people. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, khayrun nas anfa'uhum linnas. The best of people are those who are more beneficial to people. And of course, our ihsan, as we said, it is our family members and relatives, they are more deserving than any other person. So let's do good to people. As Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah tabaraka wa ta'ala says, miftahu husulir rahmah. The keys of earning the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-ihsanu fi ibadati al-khaliq was-sa'yu fi naf'i al-khalq. He says the keys of earning the mercy, blessings and barakah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is doing our best in worshipping Allah and doing our best in benefiting the servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And finally, my dear brothers, al-ihsan is even required to those people who wrong us in one way or the other. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَا تَسْتَوِي الْحَسَنَةُ وَلَا السَّيِّئَةُ اِدْفَعْ بِالَّتِي هِيَ أَحْسَنُ فَإِذَا الَّذِي بَيْنَكَ وَبَيْنَهُ عَدَاوَةٌ كَأَنَّهُ وَلِيٌّ حَمِيمٌ. Allah says, اِدْفَعْ بِالَّتِي هِيَ أَحْسَنْ. That the evil and the good will never be equal. So always do your best to repel the evil with goodness. And that will break the circle of conflict. What is required in Islam? Islam does not forbid from us to quarreling or misunderstanding. Quarrel, misunderstanding, fight, disagreement will always happen. We are humans, we have feelings. We have different understanding of different concepts. But what is required is reconciliation, coming together, forgiveness, overlooking some things. That is why in Surah Al-Hujurat, despite the fact that two parties of Muslims are fighting each other physically, Allah says, إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ إِخْوَةً فَأَصْلِحُوا بَيْنَ أَخَوَيْكُمْ. Reconcile between your brothers. They are fighting, it happens. But how well do we reconcile? How well do we remove the hatred and the jealousy from our hearts? That is the most important thing. So Allah says, always try to repel the evil with good. That will break the circle of conflict. Even among the spouses, when it happens that now there is no any other solution, it is just to part ways, even at that particular moment, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَإِمْسَاكُمْ بِمَعْرُوفٍ أو تصريح بإحسان. You either live together in reasonable terms, peacefully, or part ways بإحسان, with إحسان, with kindness, without threats, without taking each other to the court of law, without denying each other their rights, without the denial of seeing the children, or threats, or this and that. Allah says بإحسان. And finally, by doing your best in perfecting whatever you are, whatever you are engaged in, you will be successful in this dunya and akhirah before you will achieve the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ لِعَبْدِهِ إِذَا عَمِلَ عَمَلًا أَن يُتْقِنَهُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He loves of His servant when he is engaged in any halal course that you do your best in it. You are a student, be the best student. You are an employer, be the best one. You are the parents, be the best parent. Allah has blessed you with your parents, they are alive, be the best child to them. Everything that you touch, do your best in that particular thing. And if we do that, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَأَحْسِنُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. Do good, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves those who do good. And among the best good that we have just mentioned is always wishing good for others, and also feeling the pain when your Muslim brother is in pain. As the Prophet said, مَثَلُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ فِي تَوَادِّهِمْ وَتَرَاحُمِهِمْ وَتَعَاطُفِهِمْ كَمَثَلِ الْجَسَدِ الْوَاحِدِ. Muslims are like one body. When your brother is in pain, you are also in pain. And we all know what happened to our brothers and sisters in Sham, Turkey, Syria, and part of Lebanon. And this is as by the plan of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And among the types of ihsan is الرِّضَى بِقَضَاءِ اللَّهِ وَقَدَرِهِ. Is to be sufficient, is to accept the plan of Allah. Sometimes very painful, but we have no otherwise but to say قدر الله وما شاء فعل وإنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون. اللهم اغفر لهم وارحمهم وعافهم واعف عنهم يا رب العالمين. اللهم ارحم موتاهم واشف مرضاهم يا رب العالمين. اللهم إنا نسألك الهدى والتقى والعفاف والغنى. اللهم اكفنا بحلالك عن حرامك وأغننا بفضلك عمن سواك. اللهم أحسن عاقبتنا في الأمور كلها وأجرنا من خزي الدنيا وعذاب الآخرة. وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد والحمد لله رب العالمين وجزاكم الله خيرا. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.